There's something interesting that you had told me about when you're trying to attract a bird as a bird guide. What is it that you actually do?
Okay, there are different ways to attract a bird. One is that there are certain colors you have to avoid, okay? Because either they will be too bright, and the birds have a strong eyesight, they will easily detect you, that you are around, and they will fly away or disappear in the shrubs and bushes. So you have to make sure that you are putting on nature blending colors if you have to go for birding. And then one of the most important attributes in birding, you need to learn the bird calls. We call them bird calls, or in layman language, voices and sounds. So if you know the sound of a bird, it's very easy to attract it, okay? You can call it, but not call it in a way to stress it, okay? You can whistle. You whistle, okay? You give it time, it responds, you whistle again. Not whistling 10 times, of course it will get scared and run away. That's one of the ways of attracting a bird, especially in the forest. It's difficult to see birds in the forest because as you walk through the trails, they are disappearing in the shrubs and thickets because they are hearing you, okay? Those that you could sight, they are very high in the canopy. Mm. So it's a good attribute to know the bird sounds if you're to be a successful bird.
So can you share with us the kind of bird types, or rather bird species, that we have here in Uganda?
Here in Uganda.
The few that you've been able to find out.
The most famous, I can't miss it, the shoebill. Mm-hmm. Okay? The shoebill lives in wetlands. Okay? So you can only spot it in wetlands. And the other big chance about it is that you can only sight it in Uganda, in Rwanda, in Zambia, in DRC. But the best place to see it is here. Okay? Mm-hmm. There is a very beautiful bird with the colors of the Uganda flag, the saddle-billed stork. Okay? It's a very beautiful bird, captivating. We can't be in Kampala and you don't talk about the marabou stork, however much it's too common. But it is important to our environment because it helps us in the job of conservation and taking that from here and there. And it's a very important bird. And then I can't forget the endemic. We have a bird that is endemic to Uganda. You can only see it in Uganda. That's the Fox's River. That's the bird that you can only see in Uganda. There are many other birds that have been captivating to me as a person. The first time I saw a purple swamp hen, that was at Mabamba. I even lost my breath. The other place that is very fantastic is Lutembe Bay wetland. It has very, very many birds that are migrants. Yes? So during October to April, there are very many bird species.
So tell us about balancing marine photography as a photographer for functions and also being a tour guide, because I imagine being a bird guide, you move across the country. So how do you balance the two?
I have to accept that it's a very hard thing to do. Especially, you know, with the work ethic in our country, I have to talk about it. Mm. I think people work a person. So when you're not around, you realize that people lose a little bit. Mm, this happens when you have like two functions on a Saturday. So you have to supervise this side and this side. But there it becomes easy in that you sit with the people you employ and you appreciate their strengths and weaknesses. So those that are self-oriented, okay, those that don't need a lot of supervision, you push them somewhere and you go with those where you feel that you need a lot of supervision on them.
Mm-hmm.
And then for birding and tour guiding, most cases they come, okay, and they are also seasons, just like photography, okay? Just like photography, they are seasons. Like in this time, we are in a high season for tourism, okay? So everywhere there are job opportunities for tour guides. But there will be a time, okay, when the tourists are low in the boundary, okay? Especially February, March, April, they are few, okay? So a time like this, when there are many tourists, okay, and also September, October, there are many weddings and introductions, okay? You have sometimes decide. When you feel you have already booked with a tour operator to take on a trip, you cannot risk to take on a wedding on that very Saturday, all two.
So what is it you looked into when you were choosing the people that you work with, your teammates, especially the ones under marine photography?
One, I look at passion. I don't want people who come to just take photos for survival, 1 day, 2 days, and then they run away, okay? When I talk to someone, I'm able to see whether they are passionate about what they are doing. Someone who loves photography, every other picture they take, they want it to be better than the last, okay? So if someone is just taking pictures for the sake of it, that one we can't work together.
So about how many people do you employ under marine photography and as a bird tour guide?
Okay, right now I work with two people for marine photography, and I am the third.
Okay.
And then for tour guiding, birding and so on, right now I have chosen not to start a tour company as yet.
Okay. So what is it that drives you every single day, that gets you out of your bed and you're like, I'm going to do this and I will do it right?
To be sincere, my mother. My mother is the most hardworking person I've ever seen in this world. If it's to, I've ever seen her climb to thatch a house, okay? Thatching a house, selling pancakes, selling this, going to the market, people saying, your children are all okay now, they have finished school, but she's still working. And every day we ask, why are you working? Can't you just stay home and we give you everything you want? But she says, I have to work.
So tell us about growing your brand as marine photography, as Mohamed Pius, as a bird tour guide. Tell us about how you actually do it.
One of the things I really focus on is integrity and honesty. It is one of the most important attributes everywhere if you're to grow as a brand or as a company, as an organization. Integrity and honesty. What you cannot deliver, don't say, I am going to deliver.
You don't commit to it.
Don't commit yourself. Just tell the person, on this project, this is what I can deliver, this is what I cannot deliver. And if possible, say, maybe I can get someone else on the side who can come in as an expert and help me on this, but I cannot do it alone. Because someone is going to invite you and say, for example, come and guide me on amphibians, okay? And you're not a specialist on amphibians, or maybe insects. So if you say you're going because they want pyres, what are you going to tell them?
So you're only 28 years old, but
yes,
you're business oriented. Many people your age...
I'm 28, I'm making 28 in September.
Can you imagine?
Yes.
You're making even 28, yes, but you're business oriented. And many people your age are probably still looking for jobs in offices or are seated at home and waiting,
yes,
for their mamas. What advice do you have for them?
What I would advise young people and people my age is they should shape a character. They should try to shape a character. Every other thing, whether a building, you build it slowly by slowly. And what happens, especially in character development, is behavior. Behavior, actions. What you do every other day. If you want to be a prayerful person, you have to say, every day, I'm going to wake up and say a prayer. Even if it's amen, you just wake up and say amen. You have achieved it.
So in terms of growing your business, what challenges have you seen to where it is today?
Okay, one of the challenges, when I was still growing, like I said, I had videographers that I would hire and then pay, okay? One of the challenges has been people lacking honesty. Someone says they are going to come and work with you. You have two videographers, one to go to the salon of the ladies and the other for the gentlemen. You say seven, and then they don't turn up. They don't turn up, it's seven, it's 7:30. Then you have to panic, and then, but of course, as you grow, you don't panic because you know more people.
So how is it you're marketing yourself out there to the public?
Okay, I market myself through different social media sites. I am on Facebook, Mohamed Pius. I am on Twitter at Pius Mohamia. My tag name is Pius the Cuckoo. Cuckoo is a certain species of a bird. And because it's one of the birds that I saw and it was really, really beautiful. It's called an African Emerald Cuckoo. But there I post specifically wedding introductions and so on. For tourism and so on, I run them on the Mohamed Pius page. And then I also have one on Instagram at Marine Photography UG.
What should we expect of Pius in the near future?
Okay, Pius of the future, right now I am looking at maybe in 4 or 5 years, I want to start my own tour company, okay? But before that, I want to make sure that I have full and complete product knowledge. The product knowledge, you can only seek it by going to the bushes, okay? And by reading, okay? I have books about birds of East Africa, birds of Africa, okay? Very huge books, over 2,000 bird species, but you have to read every day. And so I want to start a tour company. I want to improve on my company, Marine Photography, and maybe hopefully I can marry someone's daughter.
Thank you so much for sharing knowledge, the people that have been watching.
You're
us
welcome,
today,
Brenda.
On Urban TV.
It's a pleasure.
Well, we're glad. And that brings us to the end of today's episode of Legit Hustlers. But from what I have heard from Pius, it is, whatever you do, do it with passion, do it diligently, and do it with all you can. Well, that was it for today. Catch us again next week. Brenda Kembabazi is my name. Have yourselves a good evening.